أكبر كبيرة، والحمد لله كثيرا، وسبحان الله وبحمده بكرة وأصيلا. لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده، ونصر عبده، وأعز جنده، وهزم الأحزاب وحده. لا إله إلا الله، ولا نعبد إلا إياه، مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم، إنك حميد مجيد. الله أكبر، الله أكبر على كل من طغى وتجبر. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. اللهم لك الحمد على نعمة الإسلام، ولك الحمد على نعمة الإيمان. إن The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most compassionate, the most merciful, all praise and thanks are due to him, and peace and blessings be upon his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He who is guided by the will of Allah, no one can misguide him, and he who is misguided, no one can guide him except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Witness that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is his messenger. Respected brothers and sisters, have we noticed that we started the prayer of the Eid by Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar? Allah is the greatest. Allah is greater than anything. Just few simple messages in a few minutes after thanking you for coming. وجزاكم الله خيرا, may Allah accept from you. Why do we celebrate the Eid? We have something unique in our religion. It's good that we know it very well, so that we should be proud of it. Because as we say, فَقِدْ الشَّيْءِ لَا يُعْطِيهِ, the one who does not have something, we cannot give it to others by default. Let's be proud of our religion and our system. This is a system for humanity, by the way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad, كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. You've been sent, O Muhammad, to every single person on this planet Earth. It's not just for Arabs or those who decided to become Muslims or who were born Muslims. So it's good to know the justification. Why do we have such? Why do we celebrate the Eid? Our celebration is not anything else. The first message, basically, we celebrate the Eid because we want to thank Allah. Allah is the one who designed this for us. He is the one who made it, you know, part of our system, to train us how to thank him for the fact that we did a specific worship. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. The general meaning of ibadah, ibadah literally means al-quyud wal-khudu' al-tam duna adna shart, which means the complete literal submission for the will of your Lord in every single aspect of your life, not just the ritual worship. Now fasting and umrah and hajj and the prayer, they are part of the meaning of worship. Worship is a full submission. Ramadan is one of the ritual worships in which we graduate from it, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forces us to come into a training course, to observe, to live for 1 month at least with the beauty of what does it mean to be fully aware 24/7 while I'm alone that Allah does exist. To be honest, because Allah wants me, not because the society is asking me. Last step, now the idea is not the food and the drink. The idea is, am I respecting Allah's will or not? This is the point. I'm alone now. It's not a food. Because once I'm sick, I'm allowed to eat, so no problem. Once I have any health problem, I'm allowed just to bring. Actually, if I'm having a health problem, and if I do not eat, I will be sinful. I must break my fast. So the idea is not the fast itself. The idea is not stopping eating. The idea is respecting Allah's commandments. The idea is observing. Do I respect? Am I respectful? Do I believe really in what I claim in theory? Wallahi ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Okay, okay, I'm alone now. Okay, don't do this. Don't do this. Do this. Hadr ya Allah. When I'm alone, am I having the same personality, the same attitude, the same way? If we succeeded in this, alhamdulillah, this is a sign of success. We have graduated from a small course in our life called the monthly course out of every year of Ramadan and we are graduated. Now we are in the graduation ceremony. Now part of our happiness to celebrate the Eid. Even when we celebrate by worship. Even when we want to be happy in Islam, we happy according to the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't do something against Allah's wish or what satisfies Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when we want to do it against Allah. So what's the point? We started with Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. He is greater than me, than you, than everything in this world. He is the greatest whom I should be doing my best to satisfy him. Because at the end, have you noticed why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked me and you, all of us, and he kept on at the Eid to read from Surah Al-A'la. What is the bigger surah? Subbih isma rabbika al-a'la. Then we said Allahu Akbar, takbirat. Then we prayed and said Subbih isma rabbika al-a'la. Glorify your Lord the Most High. Alladhi khalaqa fasawwa walladhi qaddara fahada. He is the creator. He is the one who shaped us. He is the one who decided what will be done and how it should be done, and he is the one who gives the guidance. So please, it's the Quran is asking us, reminding us with all of these facts to keep ourselves on the right track. The ultimate goal for us basically when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ila min Allahi wa ila Allah, we will meet him. So we have a distinguished message in our life. We are not just living to eat, we are not just living to have cars, to have houses, good jobs. Once the one of us leaves this life, he will be facing the most important reality in our lives, death and what comes after death, standing before his Lord. Alhamdulillah, our religion is designed in a way to keep making us doing the good, remembering the good, keeping us on the track, remembering the ultimate fact, which is we will stand before our Lord. Alhamdulillah. This is the first message. Second message, respected brothers and sisters. We are in a very exceptional case in the history of humanity. Humanity did not experience something like what we are experiencing now because of the global village and this pandemic. Now Eid, it was designed to spread love, to spread happiness, to spread joy by the new clothes, by sweets, by visiting each other, by giving the money gifts for each other, which we call the Eidiyah, which is a very beautiful tradition in the Islamic countries, especially from the males to the females. So you know the Eidiyah. So please, maybe we are restricted, we can't apply some of these things, but please don't forget the things that you can do. On the micro level, at home, spread the joy, put some decoration, give the Eidiyah. Okay, now by the way, through the transactions of money, you know, e-transfer, e-pay, we can send Eidiyah to anywhere on earth now. It's not an excuse for anyone. So you can make everyone happy through you sending the money as Eid, for example, okay? The new clothes, the happiness. Do whatever you can. Let your kids, let your wives, let your brothers, sisters, you know, overseas, internationally, here, wherever. Make a telephone call, video call. When you go back 20 years ago, we were not able, I remember myself when I was doing my PhD in the UK in 1997. I remember myself and I want just to phone my mother. I need to pay to buy a special card with about serial number of 16 digits and another, you know, central with another 12 digits, and there's a possibility that we'll be busy and we'll not be able to speak for a few minutes and that's it. Now we can for free, it's already paid, just complete Wi-Fi, full video, audio, conference meeting. So please, the concept of Silatul Rahim, please do it. So we can apply 70-80% of what should be done, of spreading joy, love, connecting, socializing. Do it. Let the people know really what does Islam mean for us. Show the happiness. جزاكم الله خيرا. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرحمنا وأن يغفر لنا وأن يعافينا ويعفو عنا. أقول قولي هذا. استغفر الله لي ولكم.
استغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو. استغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو. استغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو.
إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. Glad tidings, good news, beautiful news. Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said in a hadith, للصائم فرحتان, فرحة يوم فطره وفرحة عند لقاء ربه. You know, the fasting person, the one who did fast, he has two happiness times or, you know, times of joy. He will be very happy. يوم فطره, it is يوم الفطر, that day when he will break his fast by the first day of the Eid. Because as I told you, this is like a graduation ceremony. You know, when you are given your certificate that you have passed the test and you are from the successful people. You see, it's very beautiful. One of the most beautiful times in our life. Continuation of the hadith. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, وَيَوْمَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ, in the day when he will meet his Lord. قَلْ لَيْسَ مِنْكُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ إِلَّا وَسَيُكَلِّمُهُ رَبُّهُ لَيْسَ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهُ تُرْجُمَامُ. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, there is no single person amongst you, but he will be standing alone before his Lord by himself, and Allah will be speaking with him without any translation. Ya Allah! Ya Wallah! Really, just try to reflect upon this. You will stand, Allah will speak with you. Imagine how beautiful it will be when you stand and you are from those whom you are part of. For example, إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله تتنزل, إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. Imagine if we are from those. Inshallah, all of you, may Allah let from those. Or ها أم اقرأوا كتابي إني ظننت أني ملاق حسابي فهو في عيشة راضية. Ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to be from those, not from the other parts. And finally, before I finish, جزاكم الله خيرا. Brothers, I did thank you and I will repeat thanking you for coming now. You know, we are in a very special case. We have, by law, we can't have any kind of social gatherings except up to 5. Now, by law, we are allowed to have it in the cars. I keep thanking you for showing how civilized Muslims are, how educated Muslims are, how wonderful Muslims are, how respectful for the rules and the law Muslims are, which is a great message. Plus, please, just leave with this message. Whenever there is something has to do with your gathering and your unity, please put it as a priority. The people are looking at us. We need to know that we are a significant number in this country. We thank Allah for that, the law of this country. Thank for him. Allah, alhamdulillah, we have by law, by the constitution, we can perform a lot of our religious duty, alhamdulillah. Nevertheless, as they say in Arabic, تكلم حتى أراك. تكلم حتى أراك. Speak so that I can see you. If they don't see our unity, our gatherings, our support and all of such things, maybe some people will not care whether we count or we don't count, because we do count. We are hundreds of thousands. We are 1.5 million. 1.5 million, really, they do make a big difference in the system of the Western world. So wherever you know there is a gathering, by law, restricting to the rules, there is a support, show your unity and your support. This will come back again for your benefit. Because when we unite, it means we'll be stronger. If we are stronger, means we will be visible. When we are visible, they will listen. I hope the message is clear. Do your best, wherever, what happens, moon sighting, beginning of Ramadan, ending of Ramadan, Eid al-Adha, the place of worship, wherever, numbers, unity equals power, visibility, people will listen. The end, we will be benefited greatly more than what you could for the sake of Islam. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to descend his mercy upon every single person of you. Jazakum Allahu khair for coming. Eid Mubarak for every one of you. Taqabbal Allahu ta'atakum. Kullu aamin wa antum bi alfi alfi khair. Ja'alana Allahu iyyakum. Min al-a'idin in qaddara lana al-haya. Wa min al-marhumin in lam nashhad. Eidan akhara wa ramadana akhara. Allahumma ameen. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
عم غلطي شعك يا مش عارف احكي يا الله. تعال هنا فراس
جميعا على الفيس. Thank you very much. So we're gonna be leaving in شاء الله soon.
طبعا يا احبه اللي شايفينه مش عارف سامعين. Don't leave the cars. Don't leave the cars. Don't leave the cars, please. Keep social distancing. Don't leave the cars. ما أخذوا مني أخذوا مني. حياكم الله جميعا. طبعا معي بالصفحة أنا اضطريت أطلع دغري على البث قبل ما أشرح لكم شو القصة، للي موجودين معي على الصفحة الله يكرمكم ويبارك فيكم. طبعا جزاكم الله خير، عيد مبارك، كل عام أنتم بألف خير. أنا عم ببث لكم إن شاء الله صوتي يكون مسموع. Please don't leave the car. Don't leave the car. Ah.